inside our heads, this, 3 pounds of pinkish matter, pinkish gel, that is the most complex object that anyone has yet encountered. And in biology, complexity is often associated with emergent properties. Complex organisms can do a lot more than simple organisms is the kind of the basic, simplistic expression of that. And within that brain, there are neurotransmitters, the communication processes that goes on between neurons, between different parts of the brain, are largely mediated by neurotransmitters. So just as plants have messenger molecules that mediate their relationships within the ecology, within our heads, we also depend on these neurotransmitter type molecules, which are often very similar to what you find in plants. In fact, they come from what you find in plants, so that's no real surprise. They're a reflection of this coevolution. By and large, neurotransmitters are relatively small molecules. They mediate this crosstalk of communication between the neurons, and they mediate consciousness. All of these interrelated communication, crosstalking, feedback, etc. processes are experienced by us as conscious awareness. It's this network of neurotransmitters and neurons that create this simulation or this experience. Whether it's a simulation or really is reality is up for grabs. This is evidence that this consciousness meme, this artistic cognition meme, once it was expressed in one place, suddenly spread all over the world in a rather rapid fashion. What triggered this? Well, in Stanley Kubrick's 2001, the monolith appears at critical junctions in human evolution and human history. And the monolith is a sort of stand-in symbol for what Rudolf Otto called the Mysterium Tremendum, a mysterious, tremendous mystery. And the monolith, in its role in the movie, was just that. It was something that was so alien, so fascinating, so terrifying, that we could not look away and we could not look at it. And it was a catalyst, essentially, an evolution to draw us forward into greater states of consciousness and greater states of sort of learning and yearning, in a certain sense, for this evolutionary transformation into modern humans. It was a teacher. It was a tool. It was terrifying, but it was also critical to the evolution of our consciousness. And in Kubrick's movie, the monolith was something created by aliens that came from outside and that, intervened in human cultural development, if you will. Well, I argue that you don't have to go to Jupiter to find the equivalent of the monolith. The monolith, the cognitive catalyst, if you will, is already built into nature. And what is that? That is the natural psychedelic compounds, particularly things like psilocybin. Psilocybin is a natural psychedelic that's found in magic mushrooms, as you know, and there are many, many species of magic mushrooms, about 200 different species. They're all over the world, and they would surely have been encountered by early primates who were, remember, herbivores who were hungry a lot of the time and would naturally look on something like this that they would stumble upon as, quite succulent and delicious. And in fact, it is. And when they consume it, the connection would be made. Suddenly, the world would open up. And the dimensions unsuspected that are just around the corner in the plants and psychoactive fungi that these populations coexist with in nature would be opened up, and that would be seen as a Mysterium Tremendum. It would be the first experience of the transcendence, of the idea that there was a dimension beyond the dimension of ordinary senses in which the gods' mystery resided.